He is the circuit manager for Tshwane North Cluster 3. And we are here, Mohamed Skral, at the Mandela Square, attending the annual award ceremony where we are, well, they are awarding excellence in terms of performance by the learners as well as by the teachers. Dumela melekai. So please tell me about the significance of today as well as the milestones that you have reached over the years.
Oh, it is a wonderful day really for us to be here. We come a long way. You know, we've been underperforming for almost 3 years, and last year, 2015, we had 65% pass percentage for the grade 12s. This year, 2017, for the class of 2016 matriculants, we are at 82%. It's a wonderful experience not to have a red school. All our schools performed above 80% and others performed above 70%. We don't have any school that has performed below 70%, and there is no school that is red. It is a wonderful experience. We really have to appreciate all the hard work by all the teachers, by all the learners and the principals of all the schools that have done well, and they've really made us very proud because of the performance. So we are here to celebrate that.
Indeed. Now, you have mentioned, or you moved from 65% all the way to 82. That's around 16%, 17% actually.
Yes.
Wow, that's quite a significant increase. That's a significant increase. Now, what would you say were the core qualities that were driving you towards achieving this great milestone?
You know, we had very committed teachers, very committed principals who ensure that there is no late coming, there are no learners who are banking the classes, and all the learners are in class doing their work. And, you know, we're all driving to have the outcome, you know, not only having activities without having the outcome. So we are driving the outcome to ensure that everyone in the school achieves and they do their best so that we drive quality in our schools.
Wow, indeed. Now, what words of encouragement would you give to teachers who are trying, who are doing their best to stay motivated regardless of you know, the various challenges that they face in the classroom?
I normally say to teachers, you know why you are here. You chose this career and you've got the potential. You've got the capability. If you can stay focused and ensure that you do the right things at the right time, no procrastination, because when you keep on procrastinating, you'll end up being behind of your work. So keep the focus there, keep going, and ensure that you do everything that you're supposed to do at the right time every day.
Indeed. Now, what words of encouragement would you give to the matriculants who have now been accepted at university, who are currently busy with their registration and are about to begin their first semester at university for, you know, for however long their course takes?
Yeah, I would say to all the learners, you've made it. You have proved that you can make it. When you are there in the universities, you can still make it. Stay focused. Don't start to do things that you have never done before. Don't experience. Drugs are there. You know, you've got freedom to do whatever you want to do out there, but stay focused. Those things mustn't derail you. Know where you're coming from. Know where you're going to. So it's very important that as a first-year student at the university, you know what you want from the university. You'll achieve it. But if you don't know what you want, if you don't have a vision, if you don't have a plan, if you don't have a dream of where you want to go, then you end up nowhere. But stay focused.
Indeed. Now, just to quickly close it off, I know there are still other schools, many other circuits by Longkore, they are still in the red zone and they are actually looking up to, they are actually inspired by your actions. What words of encouragement would you give the teachers and principals from those particular schools?
I normally say to my teachers, focus on God. God will take care of your situations. I normally refer them to Hebrews 12 verse 2, that if you fix your eyes on the one who gave you that profession, who have sustained you up to that level where you are, God won't let you down. Know that you are not alone, and God sees you. If you are going through difficulties in terms of achieving, you've got excellence inside of you. Just ensure that you tap into that excellence, and then you'll be excellent in life.
Indeed, those are indeed words of encouragement. Mrs. Mankuruane, thank you so much for your time, and congratulations once again on your achievements.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for your time.
In grooming them for the future leadership, and most of all, in raising these families. inspiring young persons with the local land in mind and caring hearts. I would also like to thank the department for their continued collaboration and partnership with Freedom Park. It is a bit fitting that this event takes place here today, as our biggest target market is our youth, learners and learners. Once again, congratulations, and this award fully demonstrates your academic excellence and developing lifelong interest and personal aspirations along the learning journey.
Well done.
Thank you so much, Ms. Mojani, for the welcome. I hope you all guys are home right now. And indeed, yes, education is a very good weapon to actually win this life. To share a little bit of story, I did my degree twice. I know my first degree, I told my friend, what are we doing? He said, let's go look for a job, the job right now. Like, no. But then we need to change a better life for where we come from. I went back to study class, I did my degree twice. I didn't do it myself until I had to take the courage and stand on my own, because I saw that going with a group does not actually determine a lot of people succeed. I actually went to school, I did my matric, I passed the bachelor's. Today I'm here, I am in front of you. I've made it on my own. Thank you. So let's put efforts and motivate our learners each and every day as we stand in front of them. We are really good motivators in front of them. We are their role models. Be a good role model as a teacher. Teach them how good they are, how great they are. Give them pride to stand strong on their own. We'd like to have our item performances. The guys are supposed to perform for us. May they please come forward. Seems like they are not around so far. Maybe we have our choir bless us with a bit of music so that we can check it out.
And let me take also this opportunity to thank
our guest speaker, Father Mkhatshwa, who is here today to grace this occasion. Learners, teachers, FGP members, our district officials, my colleagues, and everybody here, our partners, greetings to you in the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Why are we here today? We are here basically because of education. If it was not because of education, I don't think we'd be here today. If I had to quote our former president Nelson Mandela, the late Nelson Mandela, who says the only weapon is education, or the only weapon that we have to fight poverty is education. Education is the only weapon that we can use to fight poverty. So we are here today because of education. These learners that you see today here, that are going to award today, they are going through a process, formal education and informal education. Somewhere when the teachers are teaching them, they are also using the life experience that they have with their lives to impact on the lives of these learners. So they are here to celebrate good performance shown by our teachers, our learners. We are here to celebrate good performance of our schools, and we know, we have to acknowledge that the good performance that we are going to celebrate today, that we are going to acknowledge today, that we are going to celebrate today, it is not only about educators in the classroom, it is about teamwork, it is about contribution made by the society, made by the community that we live in, made by the parents. As we know, that education is a societal priority. So we are gathered here today to say we have made it in 2017. We have the teachers taught, learners learned. Today we are going to showcase what we did in 2017. And also to thank God that we managed to achieve, not by our own, but by the help of God and by the contribution of all the people. Today as we are celebrating, we are challenging every learner, we are challenging every teacher to say, those that have made it, it is an indication that you can also make it. If someone can achieve 100%, it means that it is achievable. You also can achieve 100%. If you did not achieve it, today we are motivating you, then it is possible. Sit there where you are, and be motivated, be fired up to say, when I live here, I'm going to do my best. This occasion is to encourage that type of performance, to do your best. So we are saying to all of you, teachers and learners, happy that are here, colleagues that are also supporting our schools, let us pause today and thank ourselves and thank God, moving forward, also inviting that we are going to be more than what we have done in 2017. So we wish you all the best as the day progresses, that we know and we declare that we are the best. All of us here, we are the winners. We are the winners. So as we are gathered here, seated where you are, know that you have contributed to this occasion. You have, whether it is through your advice or through doing something, you have contributed to this great day. So I'm grateful to have you today.
Day. Let us celebrate impact of women. Let us celebrate education. Thank you so much, Program
Manager. By this, my name. Introduction of our guest. Let's see who are the guests who are going to be introduced.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Program Manager. It is an honor and a privilege for me to be standing in front of you today. First of all, I would like to acknowledge the Almighty for having made this day to be what it is. I would like also, I'll be failing if I won't recognize the brainchild behind this event, that is Mema Kuruwa, my second manager. And all the district officials that are here, the principals, SGP executives that are here, that will be running up and down, learners as well as educators, I thank you all for being here. I would like to introduce one of our own, a starlet, a comrade, who has made sure that today we have democracy in our country. He received his primary schooling in Barrington, that is in Leidenberg, and he matriculated at Hex College in Bulungwane. He entered St. Peter's Seminary, where he was ordained as a Catholic priest in June 1965. He worked as a pastor in Midbank until 1970, when he was seconded to the Church General Secretariat of the South African Catholic Bishops Conference in Pretoria. In 1973, he enrolled at the University of Leuven in Belgium, where he completed an MA in philosophy and theology. Father Khatha was an important leader in the anti-apartheid struggle. In 1976, after the students' uprising, he was detained for 4 months. However, he was found not guilty and released the following year. Soon after his release, he was nominated as the United Democratic Front patron. Between 1994 and 2000, he held a number of prominent positions in the government as well as in the ANC. In 1994, he was elected the National Assembly. He was elected to the National Assembly, and in 1996, he became the Deputy Minister of Education. That's why I said he is one of our own, and we are proud of him. A post he held until 1999. He was elected to the ANC National Executive Committee in 1997. In 2000, he became the executive mayor of the city of Tshwane, one of our own. He currently heads up the Modern Regeneration Movement, the organization partnering with many others, is the civil society driven initiative that seeks to support moral regeneration by paying special attention to development, social cohesion, and nation building. Ladies and gentlemen, join me in applause as I introduce to you Father Smangaliso Mukhatha.
Members of the teaching fraternity and my future leaders, both the same of me, I greet all of you in the name of Jesus, but also in the name of progress that we all deserve in this country. I promise the second manager that I will try to control the spirit. Yes, my father, the choice of this very prestigious occasion is most appropriate. where hundreds and thousands of people visit this institution once or twice or more times a year to reconnect with the spirit of their ancestors, to reconnect also with many heroes and heroines who died for our freedom. Many of their names are listed on these walls. So I'm here, therefore, ladies and gentlemen, first of all, to say thank you very much to those of you who put a lot of effort to ensure that your schools, primary, secondary schools, perform optimally. And I was looking at the information about the schools within the sector. Something that I find particularly encouraging is that the progress is going up and up and up. And I hope you will maintain it that way. Now, it is an honor for me to preside over this joyous occasion, which means success through hard work, dedication, and excellence. Now, the worthy recipients of these awards today are really the torch bearers of what every educator, every learner should do in a post-apartheid South Africa. Let me tell you a story. When I was Deputy Minister of Education, I'm Bashana Isikolo's working in the 9th. I made two experiences. One experience is that there are those schools who start teaching from day one. They start teaching. They don't say, they start teaching. There is discipline in those schools. Now, it is in Yazutabani, they associate it with corporal punishment. That's a wrong way of understanding discipline. Discipline merely means doing the right thing at the right time for the right reason. That's basically what it means. And taking the consequences for not doing the correct thing. What I also discovered in those rooms was that the parents take an active part in the work of the schools in their community. Over, they take time off, especially over, because I know it's not my sister, it's not my gender way. They take time off to go and witness how their own children are performing. Say, for example, if there is a sports event, they don't sit at home and watch plays and cheers for Pirates or Sundowns. But how about they got this out? So that now we are going to Ubaba, a timer is here. Umana, who called. And you have no idea what that does to a young man or a young woman. So I think that's very important. They help with the fundraising for the schools. They protect the school from vandalism. That is their school. From time to time, maybe through the SGBs or even individuals, they contact with the educators to find out what progress their child is making at school. Those schools are very successful because there is a proper program of action. What the school is going to do from January to December, everything is there. They don't allow any interruption of teaching. Nobody says, Captain, I know from experience, come to the school, they are so excited. They start interrupting the teaching. They are going to they come, they want to give a political message. Now that disrupts school. with the latest methods of teaching, with the latest methods of the creation production of knowledge, teaching methods and ways of making sure that you follow the trend. Because the way you teach today is probably quite different from what teachers taught 30, 40 years ago. Times have changed, and therefore they came abreast. But I also visited many schools when, or maybe before I finished school. Those schools are very successful, the ones I was referring to, because they also have lots of resources. A lot of those schools are in the suburbs, in white areas, Indian areas, and so on. That's a fact. Because in 1997, it was, second money, probably, you may even remember. We're not taking too many self-education. We assembled a team of researchers to visit more than 30,000 schools all over South Africa to try and look at the infrastructure. Do these schools have laboratories? Do these schools have even furniture, tables, desks? Do these schools have sports fields? Did these schools have qualified personnel? Did it, in other words, the physical needs of the various schools? And they came back with a report that I can show you book that you can read it yourself, but sure. The vast majority of the schools in black areas were almost a disaster. In terms of poverty, in terms of lacking even some of the basic tools that are required in order to provide teaching in the best possible way. But they also went to the schools, former Model C schools, and they had everything. It was not a veteran, but most of the things that they required, in just in terms of a proper school, a proper room, a proper everything. So that's what I said. So this is another way, another way of then saying to all of us, ladies and gentlemen, you cannot expect your school to perform well unless you are educators. They also know the subject that they are teaching. They correct the homework that they give out to the learners. That they are disciplined. That in the classroom and outside the classroom, they relate to the learners like father to son, father to daughter. They also relate very well to members of the community. They are honest, they are hard workers, they share the vision that I see is expressed here by some of my leaders. There's no China time for them. I'm talking about the ideal. China time in the sense that you don't find an educator who says, I don't know, students have put me in a magia, so I'm not succeeding. But the spirit is there. Of course, you don't want to abuse that as well. But in other words, these are people that are always available to do the best for their learners and for society. They also understand that if South Africa is to succeed, you need the type of educators, you need the kind of learners that we have and we just referred to. That is very, very important to keep in mind. For the former Secretary of Education and Employment in London, in 1988, he said, we all need good teachers whose skills and dedication are recognized and respected. That means a first-class profession, well-led and well-supported. It means making high standards and high rewards, which recognize the talents of those who teach our children. So that's why I always say to my good colleagues, and even to my colleagues, case that if you want this country to succeed, get our system working. Get our system producing the best possible results. Get our young men and women fired with a vision for the future. Because that is our beloved future. But if at all you really don't do the, get the best possible education, you are going to run down this country. Also, when I'm not corruption, children, minds, all poverty, there will be a conflict, there will be misunderstanding, there will be all sorts of things that actually run down the country. Instead of progress, you will get a lot of retrogression. But looking around, I'm really very inspired, I'm very encouraged. Because you look like young men and women who are saying, we can make it, we can succeed, and we are going to succeed. We are going to support our educators, treat them like parents, like college students in the classroom and outside the classroom. We're going to make our schools very proud. And we're going to make sure that the community, the same way that we used to do in the late 70s, 80s, and early 90s, to send a story, those of you who know social work very well, the community went very closely with the educators. We even helped them to start a teachers' union. We went very closely with students and learners ourselves in the community. I was one of them. And those writers sometimes will surprise you with the vision that they also had, but also with the commitment. Now, let me say that there are two types of problems that face many of our schools. One is a technical one, but the other one is more ethical. The technical one is the one I've already alluded to. You give them a proper classroom, a furniture, and so on and so on. That's more technical. And that's getting the money. In fact, this government has done wonders since 1994. We have actually spent trillions, not billions, not billions, trillions on education. Every year, if you look at the budget, when the Minister of Finance is the budget. But what remains a challenge is, where can we get him out of so much money that is being pumped into education? And sometimes I must say it's quite a disappointment. And we have to ask the question, where is that money going to? How is it being used? Is it really used for the purpose for which it was meant? So the technical one, I'm not even worried. I'm not even worried too much about this, making sure that you've got educators, since you just put it into as a management that you will do so. The big problem that is facing us, not only our schools, I'm saying to be second management, facing us as a nation, that's where we are today. There is the most going on. And if you analyze, the problem has to do moral values. And we must put on the moral values, don't think about big definitions and so on. We merely say there are certain things that are right and good for us to do and the way we relate to one another. That's what values and morality. There are certain customs. There are certain forms of conduct that help to build all of us to bring about peace and solidarity and mutual understanding. But there are certain actions that destroy us, and that's why we say they are wrong, they are immoral. Because instead of building us, they kill us. To give some examples, there are some areas where young women has become fashionable, destroying our young talents. Because I'm not driving, whether in your home or any other driver, they destroy the body, they destroy the mind, they destroy the spirit. That's what drugs do. dealers. In fact, those guys were going to make a lot of money. But they destroyed the nation. And other sides, some of them become almost helpless. This is what Jimmy and I said, I'm like, yeah. I saw for the first time a very strange lady yesterday. I won't tell you where I got it from. Someone was saying, what are the SPs are voting Mavoso? And he said, huge problem in some areas. Oh, not even in the when I even ask you, more about Lester, and then the sea, and so on. But the reason why I'm telling you that is that whenever we are destroying the future of that child, it's not child, it's not your wife, maybe your wife is at home. We are destroying the future of that child. She may leave school as a result of pulling around with you. You may even use your money to give her, buy her own things that they like, beautiful, and so on, yes. But by so doing, you are causing a lot of power in that thing. So therefore, you are not really a patriot. You are in fact an enemy of the nation. The abuse of alcohol. But also some very funny stories that I'll refer to one because everybody has been reading about this very thing. Principal was called at Ryan Park. I don't know if he meant what that is, but apparently he was using his bottles, he was using some of the property of the school to make love to all kinds of girls, even some members of staff and so on. Until this thing blew up and became public. Now, you cannot say you are going to run a successful school if that becomes the normal thing to be done in that school. It cannot be. We're not even talking about occasional mistakes here and there, people make a mistake. But when it becomes the thing to be done, it becomes then a huge change. So, ladies and gentlemen,
second money.
have a team, a reliable team to wish you everything of the best for this year and beyond. Keep in mind all the time that as a leader, like all leaders, when things go well, they probably won't even stay there. When things go wrong, that's called Shukanamuna. That was no way at all. But if you have a team around you, you have a community around you, you have got other professionals giving you support, you can only look forward to a very bright future. Principals of schools, and all the people, directors, whatever, educators you have. From our side, it's more a generation movement. We wish you well, and God bless it. A very safe future, but also a very bright and successful future for this country.
For the love they have for the children of South Africa. Because if it wasn't for the teachers and the principals who manage those schools, indeed you would not be sitting here today. But I just want to say to you, extend your hearts furthermore this year. Stretch out those arms to receive once again other people's children. Nurture them the way you always nurture them. Despite all the criticism, all the insults sometimes, level of gratitude for what you do, and sometimes when the results are announced, you are forgiven. But as your mother, I'm here to say, you always do a great job, and we appreciate. But this is what I want to say to Ungabale. There are about 5 second managers in Tswane North, and they always compete. And when I'm invited and I come rushing from Bronkhorstspruit, that's where I come from now, I don't rush for my mother. It means my coming here, getting a ticket as well, means you're going to be number one next year. Not only in this
for 2017, for 2017, the best performing learner, the best performing learner.
I thought my brain is so good. The expectant behind the success is Thank you. corner of the paper. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
hereby to pronounce or to call upon GDE Twalenot second best performing school in languages, grade 3, Skolo 2017, Tiamo Primary School. Thank you.
Boye Modilla Secondary School. secondary colleagues. The best Elena Edifushen Secondary School.
Business Skies. You've got El Garabo from High
Okamuso Secondary School.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. goes to Onilati Secondary School. Thank you. position of obtaining position 3 in second 3 we gain 4.7% goes to I Manoli Twine Secondary School.
Good afternoon. Swachangube. Life skills a lot. My name is Mbali Kamuzamalupi. From Swachangube, Mabana Primary School.
And then which are you?
Life skills.
What message do you have for other kids?
I'd like to thank them that I really appreciate that hour.
Hello. I'm fine.
What are you?
I got a award of life skills. Yes.
Okay, which school are you from?
I'm from Mawana Primary School, Soshangu.
What's your name?
My name is Busisi and my surname is Kakaza.
Any message?
Thanks for the support.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good and you?
What's your name?
My name is Kotazo. Hello. From Tani Primary School.
Okay. What award did you get? Which award did you get?
I got a certificate of natural science and technology as position 2.
And what message do you have for the kids?
Study hard, education is the key to for the future. Always take education first. Just make sure that you get 7 B's as a girl. Books before boys because brains brings babies.
And then what
do you wanna be? I wanna be a doctor.
My name is Teboho, my surname is Ndlovu.
From
Hammanskraal to Fusion Secondary School.
Okay. How do you feel?
I'm very happy because I didn't expect this. I was in school when they called me to say that I've won an award, so I had to come from school to here.
What award is this?
I came in third place for economics, grade 12.
What message do you have for
other kids? My message is work hard. Stay in school.
My name is Leseo Kutumela. Stemvater. The Fusion Secondary School. I'm so happy for winning this award because I'm the only one who managed to get the distinction in tourism. At our school, the Fusion Secondary School.
Thank you very much. I appreciate this time. As National Association of School Governing Body, we support all the initiatives that gives our educators, learners, the awards, and the district officials who are also present today. In absentia, Father Smangalizo Mukashwa, we really felt honored by having you in our midst. And then with those words, I would like to say, as the school governing bodies of different schools, let's go and support so that our schools can have quality learning and teaching throughout. I thank you.